I'm starting a garden experiment, but before I get into that, I want to do a quick little talk about bringing seeds into Japan from other countries. You need to make sure you have them checked at quarantine before you do so, and if possible, it's good to have them certified beforehand, because some seeds you can get checked at quarantine and they let them in, and some, unfortunately, you can't do that with, and so sometimes people learn the hard way, and apparently pole beans, bush beans, certain kinds of peas, tomatoes, I don't think they're into letting cucumbers in very openly, too, need to be tested and approved and certified by the people on the other side of the water, like the sending side of the water, so the company or the country that they're being sent from needs to certify them somehow before they come in. So there are some seeds that are pre-certified and some that you need to get certified if you want to bring them into Japan. And no, you can't just stick them in your luggage and pretend they're not there because it's illegal. And they don't really want to have invasive species, and so they want to check out what's coming in and what's not. And so, this is the West Coast Seeds catalog that is available, and www.westcoastseeds.com has a bunch of the seeds listed there. So, even if you're, you know, not in Japan and wanting to get seeds, that is a good place to get non-GMO seeds that tend to be open pollination, so that you can save seeds and or you can take seeds from the plant itself and use those, or you can save them for the next year if you don't use all of them the initial year you get them. They're good for up to about 3 years or so. And, I was given some to send up to a friend in Tohoku for some of the people who survived the tsunami who are starting to plant things again and that up in Iwate. And so these are the things that they did allow in. Okay, these are broad beans and sesame. This is black sesame and basil. And some starburst radishes, scallions, these are kincho scallions, and let's see which, oh, these are Apache scallions, and any more carrots? Yes, a bunch of different kinds of carrots. So they did let lots of carrots in here. Let's see which ones. Yes, and let's see. These are Pacific 22 scallions. And so for carrots, we have flyaway and borello and little fingers, Jeanette, scarlet nantes or nantes, I'm not sure which it is, yaya, this is lettuce. Spearmint, zinnias, these are flowers, black beauty zucchini, and purple sprouting broccoli. Garlic chives, and Xinjiang pak choi. So now I've got a bunch of different kinds of lettuce. Oh, and then these Napoli carrots as well, in the carrots category. And Allium Shono Prasen chives. And for lettuce, we have Fast and Furious Blend. Has nothing to do with running guns into Mexico or anything like that by the American government. That, that was during Obama's time, by the way. And Little Gem Romaine Lettuce. Paris Island Cos Lettuce, Crisp Head Lettuce, Super Gourmet Blend Lettuce, Butter Crunch Butterhead Lettuce, Loose Leaf Lettuce, and for beets we have Boro Beets and Touchstone Gold, Beet Blend, and Chioggia, and I had some Detroit Supreme and some Solyndra beet seeds that I brought in before as well that are planted. My garden, and I'm hoping that they will come up. I've had them for a while, so I don't know if the seeds will come up, and so I'm not sure how well I did with the planting, so we'll see what happens with those. But a friend of mine has had beets come up, and Swiss chard and dill seeds that I gave her before, so we'll see what happens with that. But I also have cauliflower seeds that were brought to me last year, and we'll see if those come up or not. But it's hard to know whether the problem is the seeds or whether it's the dirt or whether birds come and steal stuff or whatever. So I'm not sure what the situation is with that. We'll see. And anyway, I will cover other things at a later time, but I need to take this and send it to someone who is up in Tohoku so that she can distribute them to people who will appreciate having free seeds, because things have been tough for the people up in Tohoku. And even though it was 7 years ago now that the Tohoku thing happened, people are still recovering from it. So that is something that needs to be considered. So if you are a Christian, then definitely be praying for the people Tohoku still, because it's a long process. A lot of other people have moved on, but people up in Tohoku are still dealing with the aftermath of the tsunami at a certain level, especially if they lost their homes or family or friends, which many did. And so keep them in your prayers and thoughts, and this is a good way for them to find out that they haven't been forgotten and people are still thinking about them even if they're not in town. Anyway, hope you're well, and I'll probably do more at another time. I had to do this one inside because my data on my tablet